all stories should start at the beginning, starts with the invention of writing. Of course, storytelling predates writing. Humans have told stories about themselves, about others, about the world, to make sense of the world wherever they have existed. But at some point, that storytelling tradition intersected with writing. And that happened in Mesopotamia, in today's Iraq. Now, we don't know, of course, how the invention of writing really happened. It's always difficult to point to a moment of origin. The wonderful story of the diamond we just heard is, I think, a good example of that. So, but there is a story Mesopotamian scribes told about the invention of writing, a story that's itself over 3,000 years old, that I think gives us an inkling of how this happened. And the story is set in the city of Uruk in today's Iraq, really one of the first urban spaces in history made possible by a new form of intensive agriculture. So the king of Uruk, king of this growing and important state, has his eyes set, in fact, on the metals and minerals of the mountain state of Arata. So what he does, he sends a messenger to the mountain state of Arata and threatens the ruler of Arata and demands allegiance. The ruler of Arata is not very impressed by these threats. He sends the messenger back with a challenge. The king of Uruk meets the challenge, and still the king of Arata won't give in. And all the while, the messenger is running back and forth between the city of Uruk, which is in the floodplains between the rivers Tigris and Euphrates, and that mountain realm. And both kings get angrier and angrier. And at some point, the king of Uruk is so enraged that he launches into this long rant. And the messenger standing next to him panics because he can't remember the long rant. And it's at this point in the story about the origin of writing that the story says that the king of Uruk took some clay from the ground, flattened the clay into a tablet, put his words onto the tablet. This is a cuneiform tablet with an envelope, gave it to the messenger. The messenger runs one more time up into the mountain, gives this message to the king of Arata. The king of Arata takes this clay tablet, holds it to his ear. There's no word coming from it, and then is somehow so impressed by this technology that he pledges his allegiance to Uruk. Now, there are two things that are interesting about the story of the origin. One is that it's clearly a story about the power of writing. One way of describing this story, that this was the first text message sent in the history of the world by one angry ruler to another. There are no resonances with today, I don't think. So it's clear these scribes have perhaps an inflated sense of the importance of this technology over which they preside. The other thing that's interesting about the story is that it has actually nothing to do with literature.